start here in the local river again, try and catch a few kahawai for supper. Beautiful morning, cold autumn morning. River's been full of them this summer. Supper sorted, one cat. A nice fat one. They do vary quite a bit in condition. So we'll stick with the fat ones now. We'll look at the feet. Very good fighting fish. Great sport. Quite good eating as well. A lot of people just throw them away, but they're perfectly edible. condition fish. Not particularly big, but it's nice and strong on the side. Good little stocky, nice and sort of thick around here. Pretty big. Excellent. Well, that'll do. We'll just anchor up over here in some deeper water and do a bit of filleting. A bit of cutting and plucking. I'm all set for a little session of filleting. You can hear the roar of the sea behind me. There must be it's about a 1 meter swell. This isn't much, but you can hear it. It's just a steady roar. River's full of kahawai, so I've caught six. So I'll stop. Usually I stop at three, but I'll get some filleting for the neighbour for freeze for the winter. Luxury. Beautiful day. So I always keep the livers very good, very healthy. Keep the roe, even though these ones are spent females, they're I still eat them. The heart. The heart. And these other scraps, there'll be some gulls flying around later. Sure, and I'll keep all the little scraps and offcuts and feed the gulls if they turn up. They usually do. Gulls are around, I'll give those to the gulls. The big gulls even eat the, there's a couple of gulls, one gull. Yeah, he'll be. Give him some scraps. The big gulls will eat the whole skin. Blackbacks. These little blackbills. They prefer little chunks of fish. Where'd he go? Here he goes.
cut it.
I'll try and put one over here. The young gulls often are afraid to dive under, so they stay hungry. This one knows what to do. Afraid to dive under the younger ones. That's better. There. Alright. That's better. There you go. Ooh. There you go. That's good. Got to eat.